Hello, hello.
In today's video, we're going to talk about a marketing operations essential, and that is creating a copy deck. I'm also going to run you through how to use a tool that I've built called the Copy Deck Constructor, which quickly lets you make a template to use. So the first question some of you might be asking is, what is a copy deck? Now, according to copymatters.com, it is a document containing all your copywriting. So if you're doing a campaign or a content project, it's a single document that you keep all of the text and links out to other assets in so that everyone working on the project has a central place that they can stay aligned. Kate Toon, copywriter.com, says, a copy deck is a single document usually written in Microsoft Word. I've always kind of fancied myself a rebel, so today we're gonna break all the rules and use Google Documents instead. Take that, Kate Toon. As I mentioned, I created a tool. It's called the Copy Deck Constructor, and essentially it's a template builder for copy decks, specifically for marketing. But as with my other videos, you can take the concepts presented here and apply them to your own system and what works for your team. There's always some question bug out there that says, what's the use case? Well, the use case for this is that tables are awesome. I find the table is the best way to keep assets together, but also flexible. Before I show you how the template constructor works, I'd like to take a minute to ask you to like this video and subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions about anything I've said up till now, just put a question in the comments and I'll get back to you ASAP. Before you get started trying to use this tool, there's a few things that you're gonna need. Number one, an objective for your content campaign. At a macro level, you need a message you're trying to get out there and ideally some objectives you're driving with your campaign. The smaller objectives are handled within the template, but you need to know what your offer is and who you're talking to. The other thing you need is a map of channels to distribute content to. Now, I have another video on this. If you don't have one, I suggest you go watch that, then come back to this one to learn how to format the content for your campaign. Lastly, you're going to need a list of the message types you're looking to use within the channels. For the example in this video, we're going to use the map that I did in the ecosystem video I spoke of earlier. As you can see, I've identified LinkedIn, groups and timelines, Facebook timeline, Twitter, tweets and threads, and YouTube videos and shorts as the channels that I'm looking to use to promote my message. The objective of this campaign is to drive traffic to my website as indicated by the arrow. As I mentioned earlier, the link to the document is in the description of this video. And the first thing that you're going to want to do is, like it says here, make a copy and save it to your own drive. So I'll give the document a name and you'll see here a little warning that says app script file and functionality will also be copied. Now this is a good thing. I'll go ahead and make a copy and close the original one. Now that I have a copy, you can delete these instructions. And you'll notice up here at the top, there's a thing called Copy Deck Constructor. What it does is add a little dropdown for the different channels you may be using in your campaign. So if we reference my campaign map, you'll notice the traffic is being driven to my website. The first thing I'm gonna wanna add is something for my website. So I click website and an authorization comes up. Now this is the app script that I had mentioned. I guarantee you it's 100% safe. I am not a good enough coder to be hacking anything. If you'd like, you can view it by looking at the app script in the app script editor within your document. Otherwise, just hit continue. And it will ask you to log into your Google account and tell you it hasn't been verified. And to be honest with you, I tried multiple times to have Google verify this script. It was too complicated for my coding skills, so I just went ahead to share it with you. You guys, your early adopters, the best things in life are a little bit dangerous. In order to authorize the app script, in this little drop-down area, it says go to Copy Deck Constructor version 1. It is not unsafe, I promise. Click that. It will ask you for permissions to your account. Now, what it is doing is inserting text into the document. So these were the permissions that it needed. You just go ahead and click allow. And now when I choose website, I get a sidebar here that will help me construct my copy deck. Each one of these follows the same format. When you choose heading, it puts the channel name into the document. At the end, I'm going to show you how to make a table of contents. So always put a heading in when you're looking to create one of these. Next, I'm going to insert the page post that I'm driving my traffic to. And you'll see it's added multiple sections specific to a web page. So I have my objective, which would be to have people watch my video because this campaign is to promote a video. The keywords would be based on some research for any SEO purposes. I'll be doing another video on that, so look to my channel there. Don't forget to like and subscribe. The page title and page description for your meta, and then the article title and the body copy that will be the article that you publish. Looking back at my diagram here, the next channel I had was LinkedIn. So I just do the same thing. I choose LinkedIn, add the heading, and then I had a timeline post and a group post. Similar to the web page, I'm going to state an objective, put any text in there, any hashtags I want to use based on my research. And then the media is usually just a link to the video or the images that you're going to put alongside that post. You can also use your favorite project management software, whether it's Monday, Asana, Jira. The main thing we're trying to do here is make sure everything stays organized. With my LinkedIn done, I'm going to add Facebook, where I just do the same thing. Choose Facebook, add a heading, choose timeline post. It's very similar to LinkedIn. Then I had Twitter, which I will just do this. Now, normally this takes quite a bit of time because you're adding a table, you're adding the rows, you're adding each one of these titles and formatting it. I have a thread here so you can do the text for each one of them. Add your media in. Same with the tweet, it's similar to all the posts. If you want to add additional fields to this, you can just click in and hit tab, call it my own thing, and copy from there. It's really quite flexible. Lastly, I have YouTube, so I will choose YouTube, go heading and video and short, and down at the end of my document here, I have my video with the objective, keywords, title, description, tag, cards, media, all that stuff ready to go. Saves you the hassle, plus helps you remember what goes into each one of these types of posts. With that all done, I can close the sidebar, and back up at the top here, I'm just going to insert a table of contents, and there you have it, a navigatable way to get around your document. Another thing that I do like to do is number them or add additional information in the title, so that my table of contents is more useful. If you do that, you just click in your table of contents, hit refresh, and then you'll see your changes automatically reflected. I've made a lot of campaigns. I've made a lot of copy decks. I've copy and pasted and edited a lot of tables. I can promise you this will help you stay organized and get the deck together much quicker. The advantage of using Google Docs is that you have all the features people already know and the structure specific to running a good campaign. So you can just hit share, send it out to the team, and magic can start happening. Like all tools, this is only good if everyone involved uses it. So it does take a little bit of discipline to be useful. If you're regularly working with the same team or group of contractors, all you need to do is get everyone to do the process one or two times, and they'll start to see the value and alignment that having a agreed upon copy deck can bring. And that's it. My copy deck is created, and I'm one step closer to having a successful and organized campaign. If you have a question, go ahead and put it in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer it. If there's a channel not in the constructor that you'd like to see added, that's great feedback too. Just put it in the comments. This is a V1 of the script, so I'm looking for feedback to help make it better. Thank you so much for watching. I hope your next content campaign is an organized and massive success.